you to jot down, and then we'll launch into this subject. This will lay the foundation. I've got a few other subjects I want to share with you before the day is finished, but this one will get us started. Jot these questions down. Question number one, what makes life valuable? Interesting philosophical question. What makes life valuable, human life? Now that we find ourselves on this spinning planet, a chance to live a human life, what would make it valuable? Second question, what makes life worthwhile? Third question, what makes life work well? Good practical question. Now, under work well, we could put, you know, spiritually, socially, personally, economically, physically. There's a lot of different aspects to making life work well. But that'll suffice, because those questions, I think, are very vitally important. What makes life worthwhile? What makes it valuable? What makes it work well? And all the aspects. If your life doesn't work well in some aspects, what would you fix? And I've got some good answers on that. There's usually about a half a dozen things that makes 80% of the difference. That's the formula. There's usually about a half a dozen things that makes 80% of the difference. Now, what's interesting about this formula is it's not exactly half dozen, and it's not exactly 80%. This is just sort of a unique way to say it. Here's another way we might say it. Keep looking, whatever the project is, keep looking for the few things that makes the most difference. Boil it down to the most important components that'll take care of most of it. And I think if you look through a lot of major subjects, you'll come to this same conclusion. To be good in sales, there's about a half a dozen major things to practice that'll give you an 80% chance of really being good in sales. For a management career, there's about a half a dozen things. For a good marriage, there's about a half a dozen things. For good health, there's not 1,000 things you have to work on. There's not 500 things you have to do every day. About a half a dozen will take care of most of it. Now, what was exciting about this formula when Mr. Show first shared it with me was, if there's only a half a dozen things, I could learn it. I mean, if there's 500 things, probably left me out. You know, I only went to 1 year of college, halfway through my second year. So if it's going to take a lot of education, it's probably going to leave me out. But when he said, no, there's about a half a dozen things that'll take care of most of it, whatever the project is. I said, then if it's a half a dozen, I can learn it. So here's what I found out. Life change really is very simple. It's really very easy. For financial independence, there's about half a dozen things. No one, especially in this country, needs to go without financial independence, because it's not that difficult to master. There's not 1,000 things to learn. You don't have to go through all of the technology over a lifetime. Just a few things, major things, that'll take care of most of it, and you've got it made. When I have a chance to share with my teenage friends, by the way, I've got a new book coming out, hopefully this year, if we can get it done this year, for my teenage friends, and I think the title is going to be, Of Course Kids Should Pay Taxes. It's gonna be a good book. You'll enjoy it. And in boiling things down for my teenage friends, that's what they're interested in knowing. Can I do it? Can someone like me master it? And the answer is always yes. I tell them I got rich by the time I was 31. I was a millionaire by the time I was 31. My teacher taught me well that 6 years, from being broke at age 25 to being rich at age 31. And kids